First, let's start with a quarter circle, then in it we will inscribe one full circle so that it touches the arc of our quarter circle and its bottom radius. Now from the upper left corner of the quarter circle we will pull the tangent line to our smaller circle, and we will label the points of this tangent line as A and B. Now, if we know for the fact that the distance between the center of our quarter circle and its bottom intersection point with the inscribed circle is equal to square root of 2, is it possible for us to find the length of this red tangent line AB? If you want to try this problem for your own, you can pause this video right now and then come back to see the solution. Alright, so first we are going to do this one using the normal method of geometry. First we will label the center of our quarter circle as O, and we will mark and label the center of our inscribed circle as C. We will also mark the bottom intersection point as D. Now you can notice that the line OA represents the radius of our quarter circle, and we will label this line as capital R. You can also notice that the CD represents the radius of the smaller inscribed circle, and we will label this radius as small letter r. Now we will rotate the radius of our quarter circle to the center of our smaller circle C. You can also notice that this line will touch the intersection point between our smaller circle and the arc of our quarter circle, and we will label this point as F. Now, if we rotate the radius of our smaller circle, you can see that the line CF will also have the value of small letter r. We will clear up this image a little bit, and now from here we can conclude that the length of the line OF must be equal to the line OC plus the line CF. Since the line CF has the value of small r, and the line OF has the value of capital R, we can substitute those values and get the following. From here we can conclude that the length of the line OC is equal to the difference between the radius of our quarter circle and our inscribed circle. Now we will try to find the angle at the point D using the tangent of a circle theorem. Just to remind you, this theory states that if we have a circle with a tangent line and we pull the radius of this circle to the intersection point of the tangent line and the circle, this radius will always be perpendicular to the tangent line. We can use this theorem in our case for the point D, because if you can notice, the line OD is a tangent to our small inscribed circle, and CD is a radius of our smaller circle, so that means that the angle at the point D must be the right angle. Now we can notice this right triangle OCD, and we can use the Pythagorean theorem for this one. So, the hypotenuse OC squared must be equal to leg OD squared plus the leg DC squared. We can substitute our values from the image and we will get the following. Now we can simplify this to get the squared quantity of the difference between the radius of our big quarter circle and our smaller circle is equal to 2 plus the squared radius of our smaller circle. Now let's notice the line OD that has the length of square root of 2. We can translate this line up to the point C, and it will intersect the line OA at the point which we can label as E. You can notice that the angle at the point E is also 90 degree angle, since the angle at the point O and the angle at the point D are also 90 degree angles. That means that ODCE represents the rectangle. Now, with this in mind, we can translate the radius CD to the left, and you can notice that the line OE will also have the value of R. Now we can use this to find the length of the line EA. From the sketch you can notice that the length of the line OA is equal to OE plus EA. if we substitute our values, we will get the following. From here, we can conclude that the line EA is also equal to the difference between the radius of our quarter circle and our small inscribed circle. Now let's notice another right triangle AEC. We will also use the Pythagorean theorem on this one, and we will get that hypotenuse CA squared is equal to leg EC squared plus the leg EA squared. Now, if we substitute our values, we will get the following. And we can simplify this further. Here we can notice that the squared difference between the radius of our quarter circle and our small circle also appears in our first equation. So we can substitute that value in, and we will get the following. Now we can simplify this, and we will get that the line CA squared is equal to 4 plus small r squared. Now let's head back to our sketch once more. We can now rotate the radius of our smaller circle to the point B. And using the tangent of a circle theorem once more, we can conclude that the angle at the point B must be the right angle, since the AB is a tangent line of this small inscribed circle. Now we will notice another right triangle ABC. We can write the Pythagorean theorem for this one to say that hypotenuse CA squared is equal to the leg BC squared plus the leg AB squared. Now we will substitute the value of CA squared that we got earlier, and we will get the following equation. Here we can cancel small r squared since it is located on the both sides of the equation, and we will get that AB squared is equal to 4. That means that AB is equal to square root of 4, and from here we will finally get that the tangent line AB is equal to 2, and this is our solution. Alright, now let's try a different method, and this one will be a shortcut. It will use the limit case for this particular problem. Okay, so let's again mark the center of our smaller circle as C, and we will label the remaining points as we did before. Now let's say that the radius of our smaller circle is equal to R. Now let's consider the limit case in which small r tends to be 0. That means that our smaller circle will not exist, and that the points D, C and B are located at the same bottom right corner of our quarter circle. You can also notice that now the radius of our quarter circle will be equal to square root of 2. That means that the line OA is also equal to square root of 2. Now you can notice that the chord AB will also represent the diagonal of this big square with the side of square root of 2. Now, since we know that the diagonal of the square is equal to side of the square times square root of 2, we can just substitute our values and get that our diagonal AB is equal to square root of 2 times square root of 2, and that means that our red diagonal AB is equal to 2, and this is again our same solution. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, smash a like button and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Of course, if you found another way to solve this interesting problem, please write it down in the comment section below. And again, as always, see you guys and take care.